Schools in Jammu and Kashmir are concerned, and the latest local polls now in Jammu once again exposing the sorry state of affairs as far as government school infrastructure is concerned. This is in Rajouri district. The school, as you can see, has broken walls. It stands there as a shell. It has no roof, no walls. It's completely dilapidated, and it was still being used as a polling station for the day of polling. The polling officers reportedly were shocked when they saw the infrastructure there. This building, which was constructed in the year 2011 under the Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan. Our correspondent Pradeep getting us further details here on this. Pradeep, what is the response of the authorities? This is of course crucially given the fact that you have poll officers being witness now to this structure as well.
In fact, the people are complaining that this issue should be taken up by the governor, Satyapal Malik, because yesterday when the polling staff visited that area, they were completely shocked, as you rightly said, after seeing the dilapidated condition of the school. And there is no roof, there are no walls on the sides. They had a very tough time, in fact, because most of the time, whenever the polling staff visits there for the panchayat election or any other election, they have to stay there for the night because they have to keep all their things there. But they were completely shocked looking at the condition of the building. And this building was constructed in 2011 under Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan. Now, one can very well understand the kind of the problem the teachers and the students must be facing. This exposes, in fact, the development in the area. For the last several years, we have seen that often whosoever has been the political party there, they had been saying and claiming that the development is reaching the grassroots level. And look at the condition. This is a Budal area, Kwas primary school, and these are without walls, without proper roof. One can very well understand in winter condition how the students must be studying there. This is the highest time when the authorities need to wake up from the slumber. They need to open their eyes and look into these things, because this is not the first of the school which is in dilapidated condition. There are several other schools here on Mira. Now we have highlighted several stories where the students continue to suffer. Either they are not having proper washroom, either they are not having proper building. And this state, in fact, we have seen this is the area.
That's
which
right.
In fact, we had
and Pradeep, as we continue with pressing Chaudhary, on in asking for a justifiable response or action-based response from the authorities here, each time you also have the education secretary of the area saying that nothing can be done. We don't have the funds. For how long could one really be listening to such lame excuses? Where are the funds going then?
See, when in fact the system is corrupt, I think it's only hands remain, the funds vanish. That is exactly what is happening in the state of Jammu and Kashmir, because the central government from time to time has been sending funds. There are enough funds for their own luxurious lifestyle, but they don't have funds for the basic infrastructure. So the question arises, where actually the funds are going if it is not meant for the students, if it is not meant for the teachers? They're only paying the salaries to the teachers, and see, look at the record. There is a school dropout rate in Jammu and Kashmir is increasing. It is because of these things that in outskirts, if you go, you'll find that many other schools. Last time also, in fact, we highlighted a story from Kashmir area where the schools were running in shops. So that is the condition of the education system in such a scenario. How come we expect that your youngsters need to compete with the students outside the country and they have to do well? Despite that, we have seen that several of the people had been able to compete in the IAS examination and they had been able to do well in the last few years. First, second, third position had been from this area only. Despite that, but rest of the students continue to suffer. Mm-hmm. More than 70% students have to leave their school, so dropout percentages increasing only because of this lack of infrastructure. That is the basic need. I think the basic need is that you need to provide them better classrooms.
That is a huge dropout figure here that you're quoting there, Pradeep. An absolute shame for the authorities. Pradeep, I'm afraid we'll have to leave it at that. Many thanks for getting us those inputs. And with that, it